Hello, my name is Jason Johnson, and thank you for watching my videos. This video is going to be using the Raptor flowchart-based programming, and we're going to look at an if-then statement advanced version. So if we say we need to be hired as a mystery shopper, as an example, and our task is to rate products that we look at in a store. So we test each product, and we are going to assign it a score from 1 to 10. And the report that we're required to submit to the employer states that we must give each product a letter grade so that we can decide to develop a program that will change the number rating into a letter grade and display the new ratings. So what we're going to do is, based on that information, we're going to write a program that says if the score is 10, the rating is an A. If the score is 8 or 9, the rating is a B. If the score is a 6 or a 7, the rating is a C. And if the score is 6 or below 6, 5 or below, then the rating is going to be a D. So let's take a look at how we're going to do that in Raptor. So first, what we're going to do is we're going to need to set some of our variables. We're not going to ask the user for information on this program first. We're going to just set some variables. So the first one we're going to do is we're going to set an assignment, and we're going to put that on here. And let's save this first, and let's just call this one Shopper. And we're going to put an assignment on here. Let's make this a little bit larger. And we're going to call this one score, and we're going to set our score variable to 0. We're going to set that to 0. Now we're going to set another assignment on here, and we're going to call this one rating. And we're going to set our initial value to, and we're going to do this right here. We're going to say A. We're going to set that to A. And now we're going to get some input from the user, and we're going to ask the user to enter a score. So we're going to ask the user, we're going to say enter score, and we're going to put quotes there, and then we're going to call this variable score. And then now we're going to do a decision here, and we're going to do a selection, and we're going to put that on here, and we're going to say, we're going to open this up, and we're going to say, is the score equal to 10? So this is our first if-then statement. So we're going to say, is the score equal to 10? If it's yes, we're going to go one direction. If it's no, we're going to go the other direction. So in this case, we're going to do another assignment on here for the yes. And if it was a yes, we're going to say the rating is now equal to A. Let's put the right information in there. So now that's, we're going to set that to A. So now the rating is set to A. If it's no, we're going to go to the next decision. So if it was a yes, we go to a rating of A and we move on. And then we're going to do another decision or a selection. And if it was no, it's not going to change anything. It's just going to go to the next one. And here we're going to get a little bit more complicated. We're going to say, was the score, and I'm going to copy this from my notes over here. Was the score equal to 8 or was the score equal to 9? So we're going to say or 8 or 9. If it was a yes, then we're going to put a new assignment on there, and we're going to say our rating is now going to be a B. So if it was an 8 or a 9, it's going to be a B. So up here, if it was yes, it would be an A, and it would still be, and it would not be a 10, so it would still remain an A. It wouldn't change it. This is not going to change it. But it's not an 8 or a 9, so it's going to go no, and it's going to go the other way. And we're not going to do anything with that one. We're going to come over here now, and we're going to do another selection, because remember, we have to say 10, 8 or 9, 6 or 7, or 6 or below. So on this one here, we're going to put another one, and we're going to do this one of, is the score equal to 6 or 7? Is the score 6 or is the score 7? Again, we're going to put an assignment here, and if it was a 6 or a 7, we're going to say set the rating to C. Well, let me put the right symbol on there. We're going to set it to C. If it was no, we're going to go to the next one. And I'm going to copy this from my notes here. So we're going to do another selection here. And on this one, we're going to say, was the score greater than, and let me put this on my notes over here so you can see this. Was my score greater than or equal to 1? And was the score less than or equal to 5? So in other words, was it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? So that's setting it. So if it's greater than or equal to 1, or if it was less than or equal to 5, so if it's between 1 and 5, or not between 1 and 5, it was 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, we're going to get a yes. We're going to get a yes. and then we're going to set an assignment, change the rating to D. If no, it's not going to do anything. And then we're going to end the program. So let's step through this program here. So we're going to say, let's set a score to 0. So it's going to, in our watch area here, it's going to say set the score to 0, set the rating to A. So we give it a variable and we say we have a variable of rating, and right now it's set as A. And then we're going to say enter our score. And so let's go ahead and test this with a 10. Let's just go ahead and put a 10 in here. And we're going to test that. It's going to say yes. It's going to go over here to the rating of A. We're going to see the rating change right there to a capital A. And then it's going to say, it's going to do the next decision tree. No, no, no. And then it'll skip all the way to the end of the program. And it just kind of following the no on the statements there. And then we say run complete. We could have output to the user, and we could have said output to the user, you know, here's what your rating was. But we're not going to do that because we're just looking at the decisions here. So let's test one more. Let's go through here and let's test to see, let's enter a score of 6. We're going to enter a score of 6. So is the score equal to 10? No. So it's going to go to the right. Is it a score of 8 or a 9? No. Is it a 6 or a 7? It's going to go yes. And so now it's going to set our rating to capital C. And then it's going to say no on this one and kick to the end of the program. And there it is. It's finished. And if we did one more, let's just not do a step through. Let's just go ahead and just run this program. So it's going to ask, it's going to set our score. It's going to set our rating. It's going to ask what our score is. Let's put a 4 in. It's going to 4. It's going to go down through our decisions. It's going to get to the last one, and it's going to be in between 1 and 5. It's going to be 1 through 5. So it's going to set the rating to D and then complete the program. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below. If you're one of my students, make sure you email me from within inside the course so I can get to you quicker. And I hope you have a great day and be excellent to each other.